Hello, beautiful crochet lovers. I'm Susanna. Welcome to my channel. And today I would like to show you how to crochet a pretty butterfly drawstring bag with these sleek yarn together. This is really fine yarn that I bought at the second-hand shop, and that is recycled shop, and that is kept in new. But I think that is nearly 40 or 50 years ago. So, and I wind up three strands together. So I'm gonna use this three strands. The purple is like a shaggy yarn, and then one white yarn is a kind of a boucle, soft boucle, and then the other white one is like a string. So quite a fine yarn, but I'm gonna use a little bit nice yarn and nice texture like this, so it's very shabby color. Okay, and then I'm gonna use size 6.5, that is E and E4 in US size, or 00 in steel hook. Okay, also when I pull the string, I'm gonna use this silver string that is really, you know, shiny and very beautiful. So I'm gonna use this one, and I will show you how to use it. Okay, let's start. And this is my handmade notebook, and I designed my, you know, drawstring bag in it. And if you like to make our same as mine, please visit my sub channel. I'm showing how to make this one. Okay. I might not publish yet, so I'm going to publish in a few days. So please stay tuned as well. So please subscribe my sub channel as well. Okay. Alright. So let's start. The foundation stitch is chain 29. Okay, so please make a slip knot. And I'm gonna pick up both. And so I'm gonna make a little bit loose chains, 29. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, so please make chain 29. Alright, I made chain 29, and currently the width is approximately 16 to 17. That is quite good size, I believe. Okay. So let's move to round one. All right, let's move to round one. Round one, we need 60 single crochet. Actually, we are going to make 3 single crochet at both ends and 27 single crochets in each side. Okay, so then 60 single crochet. All right, so after making chain 29, let's make a single crochet. Okay, first please make chain 1. This is additional chain, so it doesn't count as a chain, as a stitch. And please skip the first chain and into the second chain insert, and please make a single crochet, and please make another single crochet. After making 2 single crochet, please make a single crochet into every stitch. So it's gonna be 27 per side, and in total we are going to make 29 single crochet before the last chain. So please make a single crochet into every stitch. Like this. Okay, see you at the end of this row. Alright, after finishing 27 single crochet, there is one chain left at the end, and we are going to make 3 single crochet here. Alright, let's do it together. So, let me check the yarn. Did I pick 3? No, I needed this one. Okay. So please make first one. This is the thallest. And then next one and wrap the yarn end like this. And please pick this and second single crochet and third single crochet into the stitch. So there is now 1, 2, 3 here. Then move to the other side so you can see the chain here. If you pick the back bump first, please make 27 single crochet again. 2, 3, like this. Alright, after 27 single crochet, please make last single crochet into the first chain that we made 2 single crochet. So 1 single crochet and join into the first single crochet and pull it a little bit tight. Okay, this is a round one, so let me check the width again. Now 17 or 18, and that is, oh, I think, good size, or maybe 16 or 18. Okay, let me see. Alright, okay, so let's move to round two. Round 2 is very easy, just 60 double crochet. Okay, let's make a chain 1 and into the same stitch that we join. Okay, I better to make single crochet twice as a double crochet. So this is the first double crochet. Then please make double crochet into every stitch. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, I dropped, so let me do it again. Yarn over, insert, yarn over, pull up a loop, pull through 2 loops. This is a double crochet. Insert into the stitch space that you can see here. Like this, please make double crochet into every stitch and please make 60 double crochet. Okay, this is the last stitch, so please make a double crochet and join into the first stitch. So this is the second double crochet, so please find another chain next to the second double crochet. This is the first double crochet and join. Alright, so finish the second round and move to the third round. And the third round is the main event. The third round, we are going to make 10 butterflies or the 5 butterflies per round. So I have to all collect it. Okay. Well, let's move on to round 3. Round 3, we are going to make 5 butterflies. Okay, so let's start. So here is the first stitch, chain 1, and please make 2 single crochet as count as a double crochet. Then second, third, and fourth. Okay, after making 4 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, let's make a butterfly. Start with chain 4. After making 4 chains, please make 2 treble crochet around the post of the last double crochet. So 3 loops on the hook, insert side to side under the post, and pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through first 2 loops, yarn over, pull through next 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through the last 2 loops. This is a treble crochet. One more time, wrapping 2 times, so 3 loops on the hook, insert under the post side to side from to you know, closer to farther. Okay, pull up a loop, pull through 2, pull through 2, and pull through 2. Okay, after making 2 treble crochet, please make 2 double crochet like as the same manner. Double, double. Okay, this is left upper, you know, wing. Okay, so chain 3. After making chain 3, back to the post and slip stitch to join. Okay, finished the left upper wing. Okay, next let's make left lower wing. Start with chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's make a puff stitch. Yarn over, insert the post side to side, pull up a loop, yarn over, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, insert, pull up a loop. Okay, now 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 loops on the hook and yarn over, pull through all. Okay, made puff stitch and then chain 2 and back to the post and slip stitch to join. This is a left wing. Next, let's make a right wing. The right wing we are going to make into the next post. This is a 1, 2, 3, the third one. Okay, so move to slip stitch to the next post. Here is the most tricky part. So look carefully Okay. We are going to make the wing in opposite way of the left wing. The right wing start with a chain 2 and then puff stitch. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through, and chain 3. 2, 3, and back to the post, and then slip stitch. Okay, my cat, please hold on. All right, next, chain 3, 1, 2, 3. So let's make 2 double crochet, double. 1, yarn over, two doubles, then 2 triple crochet here, pull up a loop, triple crochet again. Then finish with 4 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4, and join into the post and slip to join. Okay, this is the butterfly using our 2 doubles here. Okay, so now I use this double crochet, so next is this one. It is sometimes easy to lose, so when you make the butterfly, just mark the next stitch to restart, so that is better. Okay, I'm gonna show you how to do it. Okay, let's do it. I forgot to mark this stitch and should start from the next stitch of the last double crochet. So this one, please make a double crochet. And please make 12 double crochet. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then please mark the next stitch not to miss. All right. Then let's make the second butterfly. Okay, do you remember? Okay, let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 trebles. 2 loops, 2 loops, 2 loops. 2 loops, 2 loops, 2 loops. And 2 doubles. Double. And double, chain 3, and back to the post, slip stitch, chain 3 again, and puff stitch, 1, 2, 3, puff stitch, and chain 2 and back to the post, slip stitch and move to the next double crochet here, move with slip stitch, chain 2 and pop stitch, 2, 3, chain 3, oops, something long, okay, 1, 2, 3, back to the post, slip stitch, chain 3 and 2 doubles, double, 2 trebles, treble and treble, and chain 4 and back to the post and slip stitch to join. Okay, this is a butterfly. And now you can find the next stitch easily. So let's make a double crochet, yarn over, insert and make a double. Okay, so now I made 2 butterflies here. Okay, repeat this. Please make treble double crochet. So this is the first one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then mark the next stitch to restart. So please make a butterfly at 11th and 12th. Okay, so please repeat this, 12 double crochet and butterfly, 12 double crochet and butterfly. Okay, let's see you at the end of this round 3. Okay, I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 butterflies now. And I made the first double crochet here. So the lastly, please make 8 double crochet. So 1 here, and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And there are 1, 2 doubles here. So let's join into the first stitch, the top of the first stitch, and then join. Okay, this is the round 3. So they are the butterflies. Oh, very pretty. Okay, let's move on to round 4. Round 4 is very simple, just 6 double crochet, 60 double single crochet. So let's do it together. Chain 1 and into the same stitch as we joined, make a single crochet, 1. And next is here, there is a stitch, so 2. Okay, where is 3 and 4? The 3 is here and 4 is here. It is hidden. So let's open the butterfly here. And in between these 2 posts, please make 2 single crochet here. So here one, and pull up a loop, two. Okay, next is here. Now we did four, so make five, six. This is multiples of six stitches. Okay, let's make six again. One, two, three, four, five, six. So we made butterflies every other six stitches. Okay, so now you clear. Okay, so let's repeat. So when you think about this is 12 stitches, so first six stitches making butterflies and next six stitches make nothing. Okay, so let's repeat four more times. One, two, and open the butterfly. Three, four, close the butterfly. Five, six. Okay, then next six stitches. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so please repeat like this. After making the last single crochet, let's join into the first single crochet here. So there are two stitches here. Okay. This is round four. All right, move to round five. And round four is fixing the butterflies. Round five and round six is both 60 double crochet each. So this is very simple. Okay. So chain one and into the same stitch that we joined. Oh, make two single crochet as a double crochet. Okay. Then into the next stitch, double crochet. So after that, we made two single crochet here. So let's make two single double crochet in between butterfly. Then after the butterfly, here is the next stitch. So five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Then there are two single crochet, so let's start these 12 stitches. Okay. Two before butterfly and two over the butterfly. And two after a butterfly. And six plain stitch. Four, five, six, and two before butterfly, two over the butterfly, two after the butterfly, and a six plain stitch. Okay, repeat like this. Okay, let's join. So, the first one. And let's mark the last stitch, not to forget. Okay, then move to round 6. Round 6 is just 60 double crochet. So chain 1 and join into the first stitch that we joined. Single and single. Okay, then make double crochet into every stitch. And that is very tricky when you finish, so let's mark the last stitch, not to forget. Then make one double crochet in each stitch. Alright, these are the first 6 rounds. Okay, move on to next 6 rounds. This pattern is repeating of 6 rounds, and the next 6 rounds we are changing the butterfly position in between these butterflies. So we are going to make here and the opposite side. We are going to make 3 here. Okay, one line. Okay, so let's review one more time. So skip the foundation stitch and back to 60 single crochet, round 1. Okay, round 1, 60 single crochet is same as round 4. Actually, this is the third row repeating of these normal stitches. And for the butterflies, we are repeating in 6 by 6 rounds, okay? Okay, so round 2 and round 5 is also same. So the difference is round 3 and round 6 with butterflies or without butterflies. Okay, that is very simple. Alright, so I marked the last stitch, not to forget, not to miss and not to make over stitch. Okay, so single crochet, chain 1, in the same stitch make single crochet, and into the next stitch make single crochet. So please make 60 single crochet. Please make a single crochet into every single crochet, double crochet. So single crochet in each stitch. Okay. Okay, next is double crochet, chain 1, and 2 single crochet, into the next stitch make double crochet. So please make a double crochet in every stitch. Alright, so next is round 3, we are going to make butterflies. So next round, please make in between these butterflies. Okay, so let's do it together. It's very simple. So first, please make 2 single crochet as a double. Then include this stitch, please make 6 double crochet. First, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then please make 4 double crochet. So in total, please make 10 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then please mark the next stitch, not to miss. Okay, then make it butterflies, chain 4. and back to the double crochet and slip to join. Okay, then here is the next stitch, so make double crochet. After that is totally same. Please make 12 double crochet and butterflies, and repeat 12 double crochet and butterflies. So 2, 3, then mark the next stitch and make butterflies. So now butterflies are between these two butterflies here. All right, so let's repeat and see you at the end of this row. Okay, last, there are two stitches left after 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 double crochet. So we are going to make the last butterflies and 2 double crochet and finish to join here. Okay. Okay, then 2 double crochet and join into the first double crochet. So I mark the last stitch, and after round 4, so please repeat for the first time of round 4 to 6. Okay. Okay, finish until round 12, and 12 rounds are a set. So please repeat round 1 to round 12 one more time, so that the height is gonna be very, very nice to make a drawstring bag. Okay, so please see you after finishing row 24. It means after another round, 12 rounds. Okay, all right, so see you later. Cheer! Now I'm crocheting round 4 and finish at round 4, and then let's make the part for the string. Okay? So please finish at round 4. After making 1, 2, 3, 4 butterfly rows. Alright, let's fasten off the yarn first. Then let's move to the fold the string part. And now there is 60 stitches on top, so I'm gonna make two layers of a part, but I have to divide into two sections. So I'm gonna prepare the marker, four markers now. Okay, the first stitch is this one, so that we joined here. So let's mark here and fold. So let's divide front loop and back loop like this. So here is V chain here, so let's divide in front and back, and then let's count 30 2 4 6 8. So this is the 30, so let's dip into the next stitch. Let's divide front and back again. Okay, let's count once again to check the number that we collect or not. Alright, so that we divide it into two sections. I'm gonna attach this stitch here with a okay, let's restart again into the front loop and grab the both yarn end. and join with a single crochet. And next stitch, just use the front loop only, like a single crochet. Okay, I'm gonna show you later, so please let me proceed a few stitches to show you clearly. Okay, here is the chain, so let's insert into the front loop. Insert into the front loop only, this one. Front loop. Front loop. And please make a single crochet, 30 single crochet. Alright, after making 30 single crochet, chain 1 and turn your work. And please pick the both loop and then please make 30 single crochet again. After coming back to the first stitch, let's make chain 1 and turn your work and let's make a single crochet again. Okay, so let's make 4 rows of single crochet. Turn your work. Alright, after making 4 rows, chain 2 and fasten off. Then, next, let's do it from the inside here. So, let's make a slip knot. And into the same stitch of the back loop here. And wrap the yarn end. And please join with a single crochet. Alright. Then let's insert into the back loop only. But this time it's very simple because we can see only the back loop left here, like this, like a minus mark. So you won't miss them. There is a little bit gap here. So please make 30 single crochet again. And then please make 4 rows of single crochet. Okay, finished one side and please repeat the same thing at the opposite side. Okay, finished and now we are... I made 15 centimeters wide, so I need... 40 centimeters string. Then I made 4 or 6 strings to make it together. So before closing, I lie these strings inside. Then let's close here. So before that, I'm going to close the both stitches. Yeah, nice. Okay. I'm going to weave the yarn end while crocheting. Okay, let's crochet. Okay, then let's close it. So starting from the light side in anyway, so maybe I started this side, so I'm gonna start this side as well. Okay, so into the first stitch and first stitch. So let's pick 4 loops. Like this. Okay, attach with chain and then make a single crochet. Okay, into every stitch, 2, so pick both loops, slip, so please make a single crochet in every stitch. So please make 60 single crochet and let's join into the last stitch. Okay, so see you later at the end of this row. So I'm gonna show you how to weave the end and how to turn. Okay. Okay, there is the yarn end of the opposite side, so and please wrap with stitch. Okay, after reaching the end of this row, just move it to the other side and let's make a first single crochet straightly directly into the stitches. Okay, this is the last stitch, so let's finish this and this. Okay, and then make single crochet and join into the first single crochet of the other side and join. Okay, so now here is closed. All right, so from now let's make a finishing touch. I would like to make a ruffles or the frill here. So I would like to make like this. Okay, chain one and single crochet into the first stitch and chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a total stitch, but I'm going to usually may skip 1 to 3 stitches, but I only skip 1 stitch here and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip only 1 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. skip one stitch and next stitch, make single crochet. Chain 5, skip 1 and single crochet. All I finished to the end. Okay, let's make chain 2 and double crochet into the first single crochet of the starting. This is the first round, so move on to the second round. Okay, so I would like to increase 15 loops more with 3 rounds. So I'm going to increase by 5 and 5 and 5. So actually now 30 loops here. So I'm going to make 5 thread stitches and increase 5 thread stitches and increase like that 6 and increase 6 and increase 6 and increase like that. Okay, all right, so let me do it. All right, so first chain 5, 1 2 3 4 5, and into the stitch. Okay, single crochet, and this is the first one, this is the second one, and 1 2 3 4 5, and I made 3. Okay, let me increase 1 2 3 4 5 and back to the same loop. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5, single, please make 6 times, 2 3 4 5, single, 2. Three, four, five, this is 6, and increase 4, 5, back to the same loop. Make a single crochet. So please make 6 loops and increase. 6 loops and increase. Okay, this is the last increase. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And back to the same loop here. And make single crochet. And then 3 more. This is 1. This is 2. And chain 2 and double crochet into the last double crochet we joined. Okay. So this is the second round. And then please repeat 2 more rounds. So let's make our 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds. Okay, next. Chain 5. So please make, please increase after passing increasing points so that you won't miss it. 1. 5 chains and single crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5, and single crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is increased point, single crochet, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and to the next stitch, single crochet. Okay, let's increase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so back to the same loop. Increase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and next loop 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and next loop like this. Okay, so please increase after passing increasing point here. So that after find increase point, move to the next space and increase. So here daily increase. So please, okay, see you later. I'm going to show you. So this is increasing point. Just make a normal stitch and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and not two back to the same state space, move to the next space and increase 3, 4, 5 and back to the same space and then increase 3, 4, 5 into the next space. Okay, do like this. Okay, let's finish one more time together. Chain 2 and double crochet into the first the last double crochet. So if you are not sure, please mark that this double crochet to finish so that you won't miss it. Okay, then chain 5 and increase the last round. So here is the next point. Okay, let's move to. Okay, this is the increased stitch. So, make one. Move to next space and then increase. Back to the same space. Okay. So increase, increase and increase like this. So it's very fluffy. So gorgeous here. Okay, so this is the last loop, so let's finish. And this is the last round, so let's join with chain 5 and slip stitch so that it's very natural. So chain 5, oops, into the last double crochet here and slip to join. So let's whip the end. So this is the long side, so let's back to the long side. And we try this way, okay. Let me fast on the excess. Okay. Oh, this is my hair. All right. So. Let's weave. I did 2 knots, so it's already very secure, so just fasten off like this. Okay, finished. All right. So actually, I used the second purple yarn. This is, 25 grams, but no information about the meterage. So I'm not sure. I don't know the length exactly, and this is also 25 grams and there is no information about the length, but I use like this amount, and this is the first ball. And this is also first of all, this is the longest. I have still some, and I think this is 25 as well. I'm not sure, let me check. There is no information about the weight as well. Maybe this one is also 25. Okay, all right. So you can use the lesion or sleds to make this project alive. So here is the end. Okay, so let's make a tie. And I'm thinking I might attach the butterfly both ends. Is it pretty, isn't it? Do you think so? Do you agree with me? Okay, let's make a tie. Let's make a knot first. Tie the end. Alright, so let's make a butterfly together. Let's make a slip knot and chain 4, 1. Okay, chain 1, chain 2, and back to the first chain. Make a single crochet, then make another single crochet. Okay, then into the same chain, make a double crochet. So there is 2 posts here. Okay, let's make a butterfly. Chain 4 and 2 trebles. Oops. Two doubles. Oops. And chain 3 and back to the same post and chain 3 and puff stitch. And chain 2 and back to the same post and slip stitch. Okay, next, no slip stitch because this is, you know, it's kind of a link. Chain 2 and a puff stitch. At the time, please weave the yarn end together. And pull through and chain 3 and back to the post and slip stitch. Okay. Then chain 3 and 2 doubles. And 2 trebles. And chain 4. And back to the first loop. And slip stitch to join. Then chain 1 and chain 2 and fasten up the yarn. Let's. Okay, these two has a long tail here. This is the left side. And the one is already weaved. So I'm going to show you how to weave the ends. That is very simple. Let me, okay, this is tangled. Hold on. So this is the left side and this is the long side. So when you turn on the light, long side up, just pull through into the stitches. That's it. And just fasten off the yarn, trim it. Trim the end. Okay, lady. So one is already weaved and one has long tail. Put aside. All right. And I ironed it. So now you can see the butterfly pattern very clearly, isn't it? And this side too. And this is the side. And when you pull it like this, there is pull it on top. So let's decorate. This is the light side and this is the light side, so long side together. Just sew a few stitch first. Okay, now attached. Then okay, let me trim off here. So cover the knot here, and let's sew. So please sew a few times. Quite tight so that this can hold it. Okay, one more time just for your security. Okay, this is already secured, and then just sew around loosely. And just shape it. It's very simple, isn't it? Okay, back to the center. So let's make a knot, maybe twice. Okay, done. This side and this side. Okay, everything finished. And this is the pattern that, this is the pouch that I made. Like this. And there are, butterflies randomly, like this. So many butterflies on this pouch, and so let them fly. And there is butterflies. There are butterflies here, and this is a flail, and this is just a simple plain tulle stitch, but I made, like a bloom. Okay, this line. So this is very flat, and so it doesn't, you know, share many space, and you can use other cosmetic pouch, or you can just hang and keep something in it and hang it with this, like this, or you can use other mini bag if you make longer drawstring. So I changed the color to emphasize the line. Maybe I could do here and then add some more butterflies on top. That is still okay. So please arrange it. Maybe 3 rows of butterfly and drawstring, and 1 or 2 butterflies more, and then finish. That is still nice, I believe. This is first one, so first one always not perfect. And then I think, I should have done that like that. But it's okay. This is for the first time. First time can't be perfect. So when you make that is the second time. So you can arrange and you can improve something more. You know. Nicer, smarter, and more beautiful. Okay, so inside is like this. It's very flat, nothing, just only the right side there are many butterflies, but that is not sewn, that is crochet. And here it's also, it's very quick project, so it's very quick, but you know, it's very effective. And here also, that is 2 layers here, so that it's very nice and secure. And when you close, it's like a flower here, so that I wanted to make, you know, increase like this. Oh, very pretty, isn't it? From the top, oh, nice look. Okay, so if you like this project, please try. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.